Here's my Toronto After Dark 2023 interview with director Robert Hloz on his science fiction film, Restore Point. So what were some of your influences for Restore Point?
Well, what we tried to do was to have a, you know, we tried to have a very grounded approach to that. So actually we've been watching more non-sci-fi movies than the sci-fi ones, actually, during the preparation. We've been watching a lot of Sicario. But of course, you know, there are movies that you just, the whole crew really loves. And I guess it boils down mostly to those smaller movies like Ex Machina or Her by Spike Jonze. But of course, like, there are also some influences like Minority Report. Of course, Blade Runner comes to mind, even though we kind of forbid ourselves to kind of use that reference, because it was just like too far, you know, too dreamy for us, that we never kind of felt that it could be achievable for us.
I think like one of the major themes of the film is like, what if you can back up your mind like a hard drive, and what are the consequences of that? So how would you say the film deals with that?
Well, you know, I'm always thinking like, where does this come from? And I found out that maybe, you know, I also really like video games. So maybe it was some kind of inspiration there, like having this like save and load kind of approach to life. And also, you know, when I was a little kid, I really wanted to live as long as I can, like over 100 or something, because I felt like, oh, I just want to have so much fun, you know, in life. Mm-hmm. And so when this idea came to me about the futuristic Europe, I felt like, wow, this all kind of comes together, and it's a perfect script for me.
Good. So how would you describe the characterization of David, who's a central character essentially helping solve his own murder?
Yeah, well, we always love this kind of interesting dilemma he has, or it's this paradox. And, you know, I'd say that he loves technology. He's like one of the leading doctors and one of the inventors of the technology. And at the same time, now he sees that this technology has been used, you know, against humanity. And so, of course, he gets this trouble, and since he doesn't remember what happened to him, he actually kind of supplements the, you know, audience's role, that he has to also go through the whole history of what happened and through the explanatory, you know, like how the system works, etc.
And similarly, how would you say that M evolves over the film?
Well, I think at the beginning, like, we can definitely like see that she has this burden, right, from her past, and you know, she tries to not to think about it too much. She denies that it has any power over her, but of course, throughout the movie, you quickly realize that it is affecting her still, and you know, she finds a way how to deal with that. And I think what is really nice about the story is like, is the way how everything in the end kind of, you know, comes together, and I would say very unexpectedly solves, you know, this this kind of mystery that surrounds the restoration system, and also her past.
So how would you say films like Restore Point provide commentary on the world that we live in?
Well, that's a good question. I'd say it's a, you know, we made a future from, we made a film from the future, but actually it is not as far. I think it's, you can definitely see the mirroring of what we do right now, maybe on, you know, like social networks even. Like, we're really also trying to kind of save our past, save our history, through, you know, sharing stories, etc. And it is taking away from us some kind of, probably it is definitely taking away from us our free time, right? And, you know, what we just showing with this technology is something that is going to come. I mean, it's absolutely sure that one day we will have this load and save system, Whether it's gonna look the same as in our movie or it's gonna be a little bit different, that's not the point here. But we will get it because, you know, humanity is great in actually putting to practice whatever you just can think about. And I would say that, you know, this new technology is amazing in a way that it brings you so much safety and such a good feeling about yourself that nothing can harm you and your family can be safe. But at the same time, it takes away a lot of freedom, or, you know, gives you this notion that, oh my God, am I gonna die today? You know, you have to suddenly think about it every day, which is a very interesting change into the thinking of society, because it's not something that we nowadays that we think about, but it's gonna come.
Yeah. Well, and also, I think other than like the terrorist group, there's not the film doesn't delve too much into like the ethical issues surrounding this, like religious and such.
Well, that was a big part of the script originally. That was really heavy on the religion. But you know, this is a it's a Czech movie. Yeah. It's actually like the first Czech sci-fi in about 60 years. And what is very interesting about Czech Republic is like we are the most atheist country in Europe, and that actually was the, you know, that's the reason why Czech Republic suddenly becomes like this peak technology leader, because they are the inventors of the restoration system. And the reason why it was possible in there, even though it's a small country, is actually because there is not much religion going on. If it was happening in Poland, for example, which is super religious, it would never happen because, you know, the people would just vote against it. So this gave us the chance to have something that is really us in our core and is very specific for us. And, you know, but we also needed in the script, you know, give enough space for the plot itself. So it was a really very precise balancing between like how much philosophy, how much of the plot we want to show. I just felt that, you know, it's so self-explanatory that, and the movie just brings so many ethical questions that, you know, you don't have to explain it too loudly because it's part of the living tissue of the story. And when the movie ends, there's always so many discussions between the audience, like, oh my God, do I want it? You know, how does it change my life, etc. So I felt like in this direction, like we don't need to push it more because it's already there. And if you just think about it and think about yourself, how would you use this technology? It just suddenly becomes this big philosophical question by itself.
Okay, I think that'll do.
Okay, perfect. Yeah. Thank you so much. Okay.